everybody. My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today I want to show you a fantastic trailer. It's a lightweight trailer, and it's got a lot of qualities and versatilities. And so we're going to take a look at a Kodiak 196 BH. So here's what you need to know about Kodiak. First of all, they're really well built. They're part of the Dutchman group of products, and Dutchman's a name that's been around for, geez, I don't know, 50 years. They've been around a long time. Anyway, I like the product because this is an all aluminum frame product. When you look at trailers, they'll often talk about being aluminum frame, and the idea of aluminum, of course, is it's going to save weight, and also that aluminum doesn't get wet and rot the way a wood frame trailer could if you let it leak. So this is all aluminum, the sidewalls, the roof, the floor, and both ends. We call it a bear cage construction, and it's all superstructure is all aluminum. That saves weight and adds just years of longevity. So that's a big deal. They also have a beautiful front cap on this. You can see there's a window that lets a ton of light inside. We're going to see that when we go in. One of the best things on this I want to show you is right here. It's got, for a small trailer, it's just got a massive front storage. And in particular, this one's accessible from both inside and outside, and this opening is much taller than most little trailers get. So if you're trying to fit a cooler or something, you know, big duffels and things like that inside, you can actually get them into this front storage area. They've also got a magnet holder, so when I put this up, it stays out of the way and I don't have to fool around with a goofy little plastic clip. I really like that. Another thing that's nice about this trailer is that it's got a solar panel connector to the outside. This is pre-wired for solar. I can add solar to the roof of the coach, but I really like a portable because then I don't have to use it only on my trailer. I could take it around and do other stuff with it, like at the boat dock. And the other thing is that I don't have to put so many holes in my trailer if I'm not installing things into the roof. So I really like that. You'll see more in a minute about the roof and why this is important. Another thing that's important to note on this coach is right up here. It's got a battery disconnect switch. It's easy to get to. So if you're going to park your trailer and stay away from it for a little while, you can flip that switch and that'll shut down all the draw on your batteries so you don't get discharged batteries when you come back, go camping. You don't want to have dead batteries. So that's a really good feature. Okay, now you can see out here we have a power awning. A lot of trailers today have these great big fold-out steps, and they're real nice, but they require a lot more room, more clearance when you're bringing them out. So if you're parked too close to a tree or your house or something, it makes it hard to get them in and out. And these steps are really easy to use. They're very, very nice. Now we go over here. We've got a place outside. If we want to have a TV, we can hang it outside here. There's cable hookup right here, power supply. And you'll notice alloy wheels, got really good looking wheels and big oversized tires. One of the things that's unusual about this trailer is it's got quite a bit of ground clearance. So if you're somebody that likes to go into more remote camping areas, this is a good trailer for you to look at. Now, I haven't mentioned also this trailer because of the superstructure, the way it's built, it's pretty lightweight. This one only weighs about 4,000 pounds. So it's definitely in the category of half ton towable. Okay, now we come back here. You can see that we've got an extra fridge on the exterior. I can use that. And then right here, this little guy here is an extrusion that's designed to hold a griddle. Now, a lot of trailers come with a barbecue and you hang it on the side of your trailer. And what bugs me about it is that is kind of like a grease fire on the side of your trailer. So with this, with the griddle, I don't have any open flame. I've got a grease trap. I could still come out here and cook, but I don't have the big smoky thing right under my awning. And I think this is a really good idea. Okay, see this switch here? This is for power stabilizer jacks. We have those front and rear, so it makes it very easy to stabilize your trailer once you're situated. Now, here's a big deal. A lot of trailers today don't have a ladder at all. And, you know, if you say, well, what am I going to do? How do I get a ladder? So you see this little bracket up here? You can get a collapsible ladder that stores separately. It doesn't mount to the side of your coach. Now, remember when I was talking about holes in your trailer? To have a ladder takes about 36 holes that require maintenance to make sure you don't ever get any leaks. This one here, no holes. I love that. There's a spray port down here so I can do a wash down. It comes with a hose and a nozzle so I can clean up. And then I've got my tire here. Also, if you look up, you'll also see this is pre-wired for a backup camera. That's what that little gadget is up there under the marker light. So if you want, you can have a backup camera on this trailer. One little detail that I really like is that this has a removable shore cord. Now, a lot of small trailers that you look at have the kind of cord you're going to pull out of a little box that's inside of your trailer. And the thing about that is there's a cord that comes out and it goes through the sidewall into the trailer. Well, that's a great way for a mouse to find its way into your trailer. Of course, you've probably got some Fritos or potato chips or something in there. Mice love potato chips, so they're looking for a way in. This one here, no mouse hole. That's a good deal. Okay, now you could see here is our slide out. And when you look at this, also, I just want to point out, this is a great looking trailer. I love the color package, and it looks great with those dark tinted windows. And then over here is the other side of your storage area, so you can see again all the available storage. Okay, now let's take a look inside the coach. Follow me. Okay, so now we're inside this 196BH Kodiak, and it's a very spacious trailer. A lot of times when people are looking for a small trailer, they find out that they're getting a narrow trailer, a trailer with a lower roof height. I'm almost 6 feet tall and I have a lot of room in here. This is a full 8 foot wide, just like a conventional trailer. So it's really got a lot of room. Even though it's lightweight, it's still a nice spacious trailer. Now this has some different things about the way that it's built. The roof up here, on most trailers, you have a trussed roof with a lot of dead air space and a lot of blanket fiberglass insulation. If you get a roof leak, the water is going to come in and then it's going to get everything wet. This one here, the roof is a solid core roof. So basically, you've got aluminum superstructure and block polystyrene foam is the whole enclosure is filled with that. It's all one piece. So if I get a leak, if I make a hole in my roof, that water comes to this block polystyrene. Well, that's what we use to float a dock on. It's waterproof, it's closed cell. So that water really doesn't have anywhere to go to get everything wet. So I'm not saying you can't make a hole. You can, it could happen. But if you do, you have a much more isolated problem. I really, really like that about this trailer. Another thing that this trailer does is it has what's called a hyperdeck floor. There's no wood in the floor. It's made very much like this roof. So it's got block polystyrene solid core. It's got aluminum framing, tubular aluminum framing for all of the superstructure. And then it has an element called hyperdeck where we bond everything together. Below the linoleum, this is all waterproof. There's nothing about it that's biodegradable in the floor. So if you get a water leak in here, again, you're going to have a much more isolated problem than you would in a normal trailer. Okay, enough of that stuff. This has gas electric hot water. It has a residential 60-inch wide bed, so you've got a lot more sleeping space. A lot of these small trailers, you get kind of tiny beds. I mentioned about the windows. Take a look at all the light, bright nature in here. We have this big window here. We have big sliding windows here. The slide-out has sliding windows on both ends, so you can get a lot of cross ventilation in here. They even put a big window above the galley, and that lets in so much more light. We've got a great big farm sink that's recessed, so it's really easy to just kind of sweep your things into the sink if you're doing that. Got a nice two burner stove right here. I kind of like the small stove because most people don't have pots and pans that are going to fit a whole bunch of them on a stove anyway, so this is really adequate and it doesn't take up as much room. If we look down here, we got a great place for a garbage can. Now, over here, I want to show you this. This is a MaxAir fan right up here. This is a big high capacity fan. It moves 90 cubic feet of air per second, I think is the right calculation. But what it's for is to get your trailer's moist air, that moisture that accumulates in your trailer. I can use that to take it out. And this has a rain sensor. So if I have the vent open and the fan going and it starts to rain, it'll close its lid automatically. Another thing that's great about this trailer is it's got a nice big fridge freezer. A lot of little trailers only have like a single door fridge with maybe 5 cubic feet of space. This one here is about 8 cubic feet. It has a nice deep basin up here in the freezer. You can put a lot of ice cream in it. So, and of course, ice cream is what it's all about, right? And then here we've got bunkhouse, and the top bunk is set up to haul 300 pounds. And so I could put a couple of full-size people in here, no problem. And the other thing that's really cool about a bunk bed, when people aren't sleeping in it, great storage. It's a great place for your fishing poles, your hunting rifles, your tubbies with your camera gear, or your guitar, whatever you're hauling. This is a place to keep it out of the way. So I really like that. Okay, now let's take a look at the bathroom. So one of the design features that I mentioned, how open this trailer is, it's that the bathroom's in the back, it's not in the middle. So we get this out of the way, it really opens everything up inside the coach. Plus, we've got nice shelving here. We've got a toilet that points the right direction so your knees don't have to go up against a wall. Got a great medicine cabinet right here. And I'll step out of the way so you can see that's a nice big tall shower with a skylight. So even if you're a taller guy, you'll be able to use this trailer. One last thing on this coach I wanted to be sure and mention. This has a torsion axle. I should have showed it to you outside. And what that means, it's independent suspension. So the trailer tows great, especially on rougher roads and bumps. It doesn't transmit torque and flex to the trailer the way that it does on a straight axle. So this is a big advancement. This thing's just loaded with good ideas. I hope you like this video. I'd love to talk to you about it or even show it to you in person. If you're interested in it, please feel free to give me a call. My name is Matt Elliott. You can reach me at the RV Corral, 541-954-8495. Thanks a lot. You have a great day.